1% of all the athletes in the United States reach the level that these kids reach.
You're in the air, and you're going like this.
Kids who don't have the talent and the heart.
That's just pretty sad.
They'll weed out sooner or later.
What are you doing?
Mighty painful.
When they think of all the things that go wrong, that's where the fear sets in.
The power of negative thinking.
It's like going to extremes, like I never thought I was going to go to.
We don't like second place in this country. Second place isn't good enough.
Big five.
Yeah, someone's going to break through and become maybe the teenage or adult superstar. But how about all the other ones that didn't make it?
Allentown in Pennsylvania, een arbeidersdorpje. Een vrij ongewone locatie voor dit pand. Hier huizen 1000 Olympische dromen.
Good job.
De meisjes beginnen vaak al op hun tweede.
Oh.
Het is een race tegen de klok en tegen hun eigen teamgenoten. De coaches zijn erop getraind om kampioenen te ontdekken en te kweken. Kampioenen die zeldzame combinatie hebben, een ijzersterke geest, lichaamskracht.
Hi guys.
En misschien nog belangrijker, de onwrikbare steun van hun ouders.
Come on, don't stop.
De meisjes bereiden zich vandaag voor op een nationale talentenjacht waarin ze het op zullen nemen tegen andere 7 tot 11-jarigen. Zulke talentenjachten heten TAPS of Talent Opportunity Programs. Het doel is de sterkste, de snelste en de lenigste meisjes eruit te pikken en hen van dichtbij te begeleiden tot ze oud genoeg zijn voor de Olympische Spelen.
Oké, Ash, come on girl.
Ashley Berry is 7 jaar en haar ouders weten binnenkort of hun dochter talent heeft.
Oh, that was a good one.
Ashley, first of all, you notice right off the bat, she's incredibly strong. She's got a beautiful body, she's very lean.
Maar er is iets wat nog haar ouders, nog haar coaches wisten. Ashley trainde met een gebroken enkel. Uit de röntgenfoto's bleek dat ze hem een week voordien had gebroken tijdens een training.
One of her coaches said to Ashley, you know, your name isn't, was it Carrie, I don't know all these people, but is that it? The one who vaulted and, you know, won the gold medal on the broken ankle. But she used to be so sensitive about any pain. Her tolerance was very low. And I said to her, you know, Ashley, gymnasts get hurt. And sometimes you're going to get hurt in gymnastics. And honey, you know, you got to learn how to suck it up.
Careful, watch your foot.
Today is an exciting day.
You don't have to be nervous.
Tijdens de rit naar de wedstrijd begint de enkel van Ashley op te zwellen.
This is enough, kiddo.
Ashley, what do good gymnasts do?
Suck it up.
That's right.
Yeah, but not too much. Honey, your ankle's swollen. Ashley, here we go. Oh gosh, no, what are they going to do with her ankle?
Ashley's ouders mogen de gymclub niet in, dus volgen ze alles voor het raam.
When she did the push-ups, that upset me, because I didn't realize at first that she was doing it on one foot.
Don't drop your hips, 30.
I was just so upset. And I thought, what am I doing to this poor child? Oh, that's how she got.
Come on, Taylor, you can do it!
Naarmate de dag vordert, stijgt de spanning.
Don't give up, Kaylee.
Yeah, you'll see mini breakdown where they just start crying and had to leave.
Stay in the game.
You could see how hard they were on themselves. And I don't want Ashley to be like that.
Hey, sweetie.
Go!
Vanwege haar blessure moet Ashley de sprintoefening overslaan.
Big jump.
En de springoefening. Aan de andere oefeningen mag ze wel deelnemen.
Seven.
And it was funny with those leg ups. She was pounding them, her ankle against the bar. And this child had breaks in two parts of her ankle and a rip ligament. And it was going right through me.
Come on, baby. You got to get 20. Come on. 18. Come on, baby. 18. Come on, baby.
One more. Good job. I'm so proud of her. Her poor ankle.
Girls, let's not let down, okay? Keep working really hard on your conditioning. Work even harder. Don't stop. Don't let up.
How'd you do?
Ashley en haar teamgenotes weten pas later of ze beide gelukkiger zijn.
Where's your crutches?
Voorlopig laten ze het niet aan hun hart komen.
Tonight, I'm spinning the candle.
Ashley, do you think about going to the Olympics?
No.
Do you, Kendall?
Well, I think they're so dedicated at 7 years old. Yeah. I mean, they enjoy it. They look for it, and it's such good structure and discipline for them.
Een maand later weten de ouders van Ashley of ze bij het team hoort.
Ashley just missed it by 6 numbers. What they had done with tops was they gave her zeros for what she didn't compete in. And I guess we really didn't expect that.
Gymnast roll.
Ondanks de tegenslag van dit jaar hebben Ashley's ouders de Olympische droom nog niet opgegeven.
Go USA.
So neat. Cool.
Ze zijn ervan overtuigd dat ze talent heeft.
She does want to go to the Olympics. She is very driven in her sport. There's a change that comes over her. You know, let's get this done. Let's do our best. And to me, that's remarkable.
Voor de 10-jarige Keyla Stark is turnen haast een voltijdse baan. 4 of 5 uur per dag, 5 dagen per week. Ze hoort straks misschien bij de elite, de exclusieve club waaruit de Olympische turnsters worden gekozen.
It's a roller coaster. One day she'll go into the gym and she had an excellent day. Next day it's, you know, crying.
De ouders moedigen haar aan met beloningen.
So what are some of the things that you've gotten out of us over the years?
It's
cat.
Hamsters.
Bedroom furniture. Mm-hmm. Sort of the bribe encouragement method.
Come on, Parkett!
Net zoals veel ouders van getalenteerde turnsters zitten de ouders van Keyla met een belangrijke vraag. Is dit haar droom of hun droom?
Are we really staying altruistic to her dream to encourage her? Are we doing her harm?
Doen ze haar kwaad of stomen ze een kampioene klaar? Voor de vader van Tiger Woods was dat geen punt.
Obviously Tiger Woods is a great golfer and seems to be a pretty good kid. He has ruined my life. The last 5 years.
Bob Bigelow vecht tegen de bierkaai. Hij vecht tegen een hypercompetitieve jongerensportcultuur. Hij is een voormalig professioneel basketbalspeler en de auteur van Just Let the Kids Play. Hij zegt dat te veel ouders hun kinderen dwingen om te worden net zoals Tiger Woods.
When I was a child, the vast majority of my sporting activities were playgrounds and sandlots. Just like this place here.
Who's the faster one? Let's see. So let's go.
Now the majority of our youth sports activities are organized and governed and administrated by adults.
Yes, look at that.
In Virginia is er bij ouders een grote vraag naar lessen voor kinderen vanaf 3 jaar.
Yay!
This is her second sport. Tennis is really her first sport. So maybe one day she'll be the next Venus or Serena. We're hoping.
You do it all the way around.
Ouders hopen en betalen meer dan ooit tevoren.
These kids are paying anywhere from $500 to $1,500 just to join the team, and then they have to buy all the accessories. By the time you're done with the hotel fees and everything, you might have spent $5,000 on your kid by the end of the year.
Joe Cipollone is een vader van softballspelers.
It's very competitive today. If you're sitting on the sidelines and you're watching your kids not play, it really gets tough.
Hoe kwetsend?
42-year-old Thomas Junta, a father of two, turned himself into police in the Boston suburb of Reading.
The doctor told me and my family that my dad was dead.
What made this case resonate with so many? What started it all? Passions out of control over a game children played.
The biggest problem in organized youth sports is very simple to explain. Too many adults who want to compete through children.
Welke invloed hebben zulke ambitieuze ouders op hun kinderen? Kinderpsychiater Alvin Rosenfeld.
I think kids feel that they're going to be winners or they're going to be nothing. I think there's every reason to believe that this overscheduled lifestyle is directly connected to the amount of ADD, depression, eating disorders, etc. that we're seeing.
You're going to start on this month?
Brenda Uselak is the mother of an elite turnster and she is also a coach.
Series. You do have a lot that the parents, I think, want to live the gymnastic world through their kids. And some of them just really are miserable, but they keep doing it because they want to keep their parents happy. That's usually the type of kid that will be a very talented gymnast, but in the end will burn out.
75% van alle kinderen geven hun sport op voor hun 12e. Waarom? Ze vinden het gewoon niet leuk meer.
Slow, slow.
Our biggest fear for Kayla is to get in that rut, quit, and then regret.
Good girl.
If she begins to have doubts, should we encourage her to quit because it's taking away her childhood or other aspects of her life that maybe she wants back? And some days, as parents, we're like, you know what? Quit. Pull the plug. Please, you know, let us off this train.
What we are in youth sports to do is to develop better children.
Bob Bigelow heeft een boodschap voor elke ouder. Dirigeer de activiteiten van je kind niet en laat het gewoon spelen.
You're kicking first. You're on my team.
The honest answer is they don't need us. I'm trying to bring the competitive nature of youth sports back to the children, where it belongs.
In de gymclub Parkettes in Allentown in Pennsylvania zijn de elite turnsters de paradepaardjes.
You get the blue right over there.
Om aan de top te blijven, trainen ze het hele jaar door 6 dagen per week. Ze hebben minder dan 2 weken vakantie. Ze krijgen allemaal thuisscholing. De moeder van de 7-jarige Ashley Barry bestudeert de eliteploeg om te weten wat haar te wachten staat.
And look at the older girls.
All the way through your toes, guys.
And I just can't imagine. In a way, I hope that she decides she doesn't like it, because it's hard. I mean, it's a lot of sacrifices for the family when it gets up to the higher levels.
Who's Nicole Harris?
Nicole Harris, she's like the troublemaker right there.
Nicole Harris zit bij de elite.
That's an excellent job.
Op haar 13e verliet ze New York en haar familie om in deze gymclub te komen trainen. Dat betekent dat ze bij teamgenoten in Allentown moest wonen. Haar coaches zeggen dat ze heel wat talent heeft, maar soms spelen haar emoties haar parten.
I get very frustrated. Like I want to do something perfect and I can't and I try over and over and then I get so mad.
Wait a second. Where are you going?
Nicole. Now, Miss Flexibility. Oh, my utmost challenge. Loves to be on stage. Loves to be number one. Gets very, very upset when she isn't.
You see this? I lost half of that because of Nicole. 5 different moves of Nicole Harris.
1, 2.
Op het elite niveau moeten de meisjes streven naar perfectie en hun ouders worden er vaak in meegesleurd.
Okay, ready?
Boxes.
Vandaag verhuizen de ouders en de jongere zussen van Nicole naar Allentown. Ze laten hun oude leven achter zich en volgen Nicole in haar Olympische droom.
So how old were you when you wrote that? 8?
I thought.
She wrote that as would be her signature. When she wins gold in 2004.
Yeah.
My last day in the OR.
Nicole's moeder laat een carrière van 16 jaar achter.
I wish you and your family, and especially your daughter, who is the reason for all of this, nothing but the best.
Here.
Haar jongere zus Kim heeft zo haar bedenkingen.
I don't want to leave my friends, and next year is fifth grade, and I want to graduate with all my friends.
Taking care of business!
Nicole gets whatever she wants. Yesterday, I asked for something, and my parents said no, and then my sister asked for two things, and I said yes, and my dad took her to get it.
De vader van Nicole wil zijn baan als brandweerman in New York houden en zal telkens 2,5 uur heen en terug moeten pendelen.
Remember this, Dolly?
Ja.
Look how small you are.
Haar ouders zeggen dat ze moet putten uit Nicole's volharding.
I say to myself, we should just stop all this. But that's not Nicole. She wants to go and she wants to do this, so we're going. You know, I can't imagine Nicole without it in her life.
Pull up and square out.
Haar familie heeft misschien vertrouwen in Nicole, maar zelf loopt ze niet altijd over van zelfvertrouwen.
Nice and straight.
Hey. Oh. Unbelievable.
You gotta believe in yourself. Remember, you don't have to hammer and work so hard. Come on now, nice and straight. Straight legs.
Sometimes it gets very hard and you're like, I can't do this anymore.
I like this pass. You just, you know, I don't have enough rest before.
I want to do it. I really do.
You know my answer to that. Talk's cheap, baby.
Nicole, where's your pride? You got to fight through you. You got to fight through this emotional baloney. You know what your problem is? You care too much. Just relax. You're too intense. You're trying too hard. You're working too hard. Just relax. Okay? Just chill out. Just chill out. Okay.
Nu de ouders van Nicole hun oude leven terug toekeren, vraagt ook Nicole zich af wat ze allemaal moet missen.
I mean, I'd like to see what it'd be like if I didn't do gymnastics. We all do. We all say, what would it be like? We all do. We always talk about that. Come on. I don't think I'd be able to go back to school and feel normal ever again. I don't think I could.
Again, five times.
Nicole Harris is een van de 9 elite turnsters bij Parkettes. Ieder van hen zou de volgende Olympische ster kunnen worden.
Come on, Annie, over the top.
I'm 12.
Sharp, sharper. Open and open again.
And I've been in elite. This is going to be my second year.
Annie Fogarty is een van de jongste in de ploeg.
Just because you're only 12 years old doesn't mean you have to look like a 12-year-old.
Sometimes if like something's aching, your mind's saying, okay, stop, you can't do it anymore. But then your heart's like, you have to do it.
Christina Kosia, die in de gymclub bekend staat als Shawky, heeft met vallen en opstaan de elite bereikt.
I told her a couple times, I said, look, it's just chewing everybody up. I mean, if you're not going to take that next step, then let's just get out. And she would just look at me and say, no. Okay, Shark, whatever you want.
Christa Jasper is volgens de coaches een natuurtalent.
She's a performer. She loves to perform. She's an American Idol. She should see an Olympic team eventually. You can't do any less than what I'm asking, or you might as well not do it.
De meisjes staan voortdurend onder druk.
Come on, Sharky.
Die druk gaat niet alleen van henzelf uit, maar ook van de coaches die hen op elke fout en elk detail wijzen.
Do you see this? These are all deductions, okay? Just stay with it.
Coach Donna zegt dat deze sport goed is voor de meisjes. Het maakt hen vroeg volwassen.
You're in this position, Crystal. I don't care that you don't feel like doing this.
I find that teenagers today don't have a work ethic.
I said I want it too.
Gymnasts have a very good work ethic.
Feet,
in, shoulders back.
And they know how to budget their time, and they know how to strive.
How easy was that?
We're going to keep going till we do.
Donna en haar man Bill zijn al meer dan 30 jaar de bazen van de gymclub Parkettes. Ze gebruiken verschillende trainingstechnieken om van pubers perfect afgestelde machines te maken.
Good, yeah, there you go.
What? I don't know about your event, but they're doing great on board.
If you're having a bad day, he'll give you a hug. He'll sit down and talk to you. The big bear hug.
But they play the good cop, bad cop pretty good.
Yeah.
Come on, Donna, they know what they're doing. They got their act together.
I won't comment, but just take that out. I don't want to even see it.
Donna's always more strict and stern with them.
Listen to me, demand.
She'll push them just as hard as she thinks she can push them. And that's what makes champions. That's why Parkettes has the legacy that they have, and that's why they have the elite team that they have.
Where's the dismount? Did you not listen to the following directions?
When Donna wants her way, she gets her way.
It has that feeling.
Donna wil bij Annie meer schittering zien.
Come on, arms, sail, Annie, sail! Perform!
My coaches always remind me, you have to have personality, and sometimes I don't.
And back!
Like, smile and be like, showy, and sometimes I don't like to do that in front of people.
And if you're not going to work to the level of this group, you're moving back, and that's not a threat, it's a fact.
We coach Annie hard. The job that we have to do with Annie is daily.
Don't just jump off.
It's daily reminding her for her work ethic, for her belief in herself, for the constant output.
What Annie will is meer knuffels.
I would like that.
Yeah, I don't think that's something you're ever going to have to worry about. Over-hugging is not likely.
Yeah. Do it tight.
Morgen is er een wedstrijd. Annie's ouders stellen haar op haar gemak. Maar de verwachtingen van haar coaches zijn duidelijk. Een brede glimlach en geen fouten. Shawky overstijgt haar eigen verwachtingen. Maar Nicole weet dat ze beter kon.
I keep telling you, stop second guessing yourself. Let's show a little bit of maturity here, please.
De coaches houden Annie in de gaten. Ze willen weten of ze de wedstrijddruk wel aan kan.
Oh man, gosh, what the heck was that?
Come on, Annie.
Well, I try to picture just like me and the beam and nobody else. But sometimes I get nervous and like shaking. I don't like that. I just tell myself to have fun and try my best because that's what really counts.
Haar coaches zijn niet tevreden over haar prestatie.
Annie, why are you competing? What is the purpose of competition? To try to win? Do your very best? I mean, do you have any goals? Or do you just think it's more important to have bobbles so people give you attention? I mean, what is the purpose of that performance level?
I think she was mad.
We have other stuff that could go in, but we can't put it in because you just aren't ready for it. And I'm not done, because I'm tired. I'm very angry right now at you.
I think she just was talking about you need to focus more and practice.
Oh, yeah. I didn't really get why she said that, but I don't know.
If some kids walk in here thinking that they're great, even when they're not, she does the opposite. Like, she could be really great right now.
Well, I hear where you're coming from.
And I think that's the point she was trying to say, you know, treating every day like an important day.
Annie, come here, please.
But it's not an easy thing to do.
Think what you're doing now, Lou. Stop with the faces.
Eisen volwassenen te veel van deze meisjes?
Solomon, could you like help with her?
Kinderpsychiater Alvin Rosenfeld vindt van wel.
Just settle yourself down.
Kids are not being permitted to be kids. They're being forced to be professionals. And I think we're robbing their childhood.
They're kids.
Annie, that was a great ball. Sticky.
And if there's not someone there motivating and demanding the finished product, they're not going to put in 100% effort.
I couldn't what?
Control it.
Why?
So it's all what the coaches demand.
Why? Use your arms instead of your head and that won't happen.
Op de elitewedstrijd in Allentown voelt Christina, of Sharky zoals ze genoemd wordt, zich kiplekker.
I connected all of my skills and got a really good score. And that got me even more pumped up for floor.
Over. Come on, push it, push! Come on, come on.
Thanks. All right. Keep coming, keep coming. Sit down. Today. Wap your head?
Hmm? On my last pass, I think I got a little bit over anxious and I missed my legs on my double pike and landed on my head and had a little bit of a concussion.
She was having an excellent meet, and when she did that, it's like everything just drains out of you. You know, it's like, oh, you know, now what? You know, it's hard to see him fall like that.
Work your arms in the double A. Okay. Work straight! Right up, right up! Don't let him know it hurt!
Sharky gaat weer trainen voor de volgende belangrijke wedstrijd. Ze heeft te kampen met een peesontsteking en hielspoor. Een ontsteking van de peesplaat in de hiel.
So what did I tell you when your heels were hurting you?
Suck it up.
Suck it up.
Because there's nothing you can do. There's nothing for the heels you can do, so it's like... Suck it up. You'll be okay.
That's what I just told her. I said,
you
got to stick with it.
Olympisch turnster Kristen Maloney trainde bij Parkets, waar haar doorzettingsvermogen legendarisch werd.
Did she say when I was done icing?
Nu is ze tijdelijk buiten de strijd bij de gymploeg van de Universiteit van Californië.
I've had 4 surgeries on it, had a couple rods put in, had some dead bones scraped out and stuff like that. But I just didn't want to heal.
Elite turnsters zoals Kristen zijn een uitdaging voor dokters, zegt haar ploegdokter.
They've learned to ignore signs of pain, which obviously that's not a good thing.
Maar volgens coach Donna is een hoge pijngrens de beste troef voor een toekomstige kampioene.
You know, we've had gymnasts that have injuries and if the doctor tells them it's not going to get worse. And if you can work with pain, you can do it. And we've had kids able to do that and some can't. And that has to come from them.
De jeugdsport wordt steeds competitiever, de seizoenen langer en de trainingen uitgebreider. Daardoor krijgen dokters meer over belastingsblessures in hun praktijk, zo'n 8 miljoen per jaar. In honkbal, atletiek, zwemmen en turnen hebben kinderen tegenwoordig letsels die 20 jaar geleden ondenkbaar waren.
Instead of free play that we used to see when we were younger,
tight body.
We're seeing young kids that are exercising from 4 to 6 hours a day, 5 to 6 days a week.
I will.
So we're seeing a lot more problems with burnout, with overuse injuries.
Go, go, go!
Thank goodness it's Friday.
Been back doing your usual training? Haven't stopped at all?
Geblesseerde meisjes komen terecht bij dokter Gregor Hauk. Dit meisje moest de laatste wedstrijd uitzitten omdat ze rugpijn had.
So now if I bring you up and over this way, any pain?
Yeah.
Dokter Hauk ging na of ze scheurtjes had in haar ruggengraat, maar hij kon niks vinden. Ondanks de overbelasting mag ze aan de volgende wedstrijd deelnemen.
Gymnasts are so very active, we can't do what we do to an average athlete or a high school athlete and put them at rest and let them heal. If we do that, she'll lose her season.
Oh, nice.
Nicole Harris is ook aan het trainen met rugpijn.
I think that no matter how much it hurts, you just have to deal with it. And the coach tried to tell me that.
There's a very fine line when you can are allowed to step in as the parent. You're like, wait a minute, this is my kid. This will always be my kid. But you have to like kind of walk on eggshells with it.
De meisjes moeten niet alleen met pijn leren omgaan, ze moeten ook op hun gewicht letten.
If you don't teach them at a young age how to
control their bodies. When they hit 14, 15, you have a big problem.
Nicole is 14 en weet dat haar coaches belang hebben bij wat ze eet.
I just want regular pizza.
I want to stop talking about food. They're going to get it on camera and then Mrs. Stress is going to say, I don't get that.
Maar één opmerking van een coach kan voor een perfectionistische puber de aanleiding geven tot eetstoornissen.
They're like God sometimes to the gymnast, and what they say is like gospel to the gymnast. They need to be very careful.
Okay. If there's meat coming up, you get weighed. I mean, it's the difference between like a quarter pound.
It's all the way tight.
I didn't have a scale till, I don't know, 6 months ago, because I knew she would be obsessive about it, and she is.
De coaches van Parkets zeggen dat ze een meisje met een eetstoornis gewoon de deur wijzen.
Unfortunately, we have seen athletes in their 20s that have had all of those problems, and they unfortunately have, some of them have had bones of a 70-year-old.
Overbelasting kan ook de groei en de puberteit een tijd belemmeren, wat niet noodzakelijk negatief wordt gevonden in de gymnastiek.
If you grow 4 inches, it just changes everything. The mass, the body, the frame. If you grow that much, it's just going to make it that much worse.
Klein, smal en prepuberaal is de norm sinds de Olympische turnster Nadia Comăneci op haar 14e een perfecte 10 haalde. Ze was 1,52 meter en woog 38,5 kilo. Maar perfectie eist zijn tol, zegt kinderpsychiater Elvin Rosenfeld.
If your goal is to be perfect, you always will be inadequate. And you always will have a problem with your self-esteem. If your goal is to be the best you can be and to really try hard, you'll do fine.
Na deze wedstrijd in Virginia Beach komen turnsters uit alle staten van Amerika in de hoop als nieuw talent ontdekt te worden.
No matter what happens, okay? I want to see you up your performance level.
Come on, Annie.
Annie's coaches hopen dat ze indruk zal maken op de jury.
It's okay, Annie. Keep her going.
Way to give up, Annie. Way to give up.
I just say, thank God, I'm done.
Was that a try, what you just did? What kind of a try? Is there such a thing as a quitter's try, like lackadaisical?
Come on, Nicole!
Let's see what Nicole does on floor.
Coach Bill maakt zich zorgen over Nicole. Hij vraagt zich af of ze de dubbele achterwaartse salto zal halen die tijdens de training altijd mislukte.
Yep. Every 10th counts, all right? Come on, buddy, you can do it.
Very well, sweetie. I can see a smile on her face every so often.
A floor routine.
Nicole heeft haar angsten overwonnen.
Okay, very good. Don't you think you should do a double layout without a spot?
Nu moet Sharky de haren nog overwinnen.
Then you're gonna be choked by me if you mess it, so.
She wouldn't be here if she wasn't good. I just gotta believe that. And she'll be fine.
Legs tight. Yeah,
Sharky's coaches zijn bang dat ze haar Achillespees gescheurd
relax.
Heeft.
Relax. Can you get her? Because I'm gonna get Tia. Tia's next.
She'll be okay. She's tough.
Well, she's semi-walking. That's always your goal, to walk out of here. Hello. We'll see what happens. Back to the mill on Monday.
Sharky's seizoen is voorbij. De andere meisjes krijgen te horen of ze gekwalificeerd zijn voor het nationale kampioenschap. Nicole eindigt op de 5e plaats. En van haar teamgenotes wordt Taya 6e, Krista 8e en Annie 10e. Op de 19e plaats kwalificeert Lou zich ook. Zij hebben de eerste schifting voor de Olympische Spelen overleefd. Hierna volgen nog veel wedstrijden en weinig garanties. Nicole haar harde werk heeft gerendeerd. Maar Shawky heeft een harde les moeten leren.
These kids are out there on the spotlight, just by themselves, and they have one shot. And if they're doing a floor routine that they've nailed 50 times of practice, and like a classic, she didn't get up, and she got hurt, that's it. Day's done. Year's done. No nationals, no nothing.
Very good.
Is het dat allemaal waard? Hoe ver mogen kinderen, ouders en coaches gaan om een droom te verwezenlijken?
Cover of Sports Illustrated. The new Mary Blue.
Christy Phillips bereikte de top. Ze begon op haar vierde, verhuisde op haar achtste om met een betere coach te kunnen trainen en werd op haar veertiende de volgende Mary Lou Retton genoemd.
I enjoyed the attention, I enjoyed the popularity, but didn't quite realize what else came with it. You know, if I didn't perform, if I wasn't the best, knowing that if I didn't make this, those last 8 years of my life that I've lived away from home, that my brothers have eaten ramen noodles for weeks because they don't have money to go to the grocery store, I had all that on my shoulders. I knew that they were counting on me to fulfill a dream and hopefully be able to reimburse, you know, get something tangible out of it. And that didn't happen.
Het is niet gebeurd omdat haar puberteit de kop opstak in een Olympisch jaar.
I became held responsible for the way my body was changing. I can't stop nature, dudes.
Christy was invaller voor het Olympische team van 1988, maar ze mocht niet vertrekken.
You know, and that was like devastation. I didn't win the Olympics. That's what I was supposed to do. Since I didn't do it, I was a failure.
Op haar 17e schreef Christy in een brief aan haar moeder dat ze haar leven beu was. Ze had dringend hulp nodig.
I didn't know who I was. Gymnastics was my life. It was not a part of my life.
Op haar 19e vertrok Kristen Maloney wel naar de Spelen. Volgens haar was het de opoffering waard.
I don't know. It's kind of like a dream come true to make the Olympics. It was a hard but good journey that I went through.
En waagt ze volgend jaar nog een poging?
I don't think so. Because it's a lot of hard work. And to be honest, I don't think my body could take it anymore. I just want to finish out college and figure out what I'm going to do for the rest of my life.
What's the most important thing about today's competition?
Having fun.
You go, girl!
Na enkele moeilijke jaren heeft Christy Phillips eindelijk ontdekt wat ze met haar leven wil doen. Ze heeft onlangs een gymclub geopend in North Carolina, waar ze liever het zelfvertrouwen van kinderen opkrikt en kampioens creëert.
They're like glass that if you break them too many times, they're not going to be able to put themselves back together.
If you stay like this,
they're not going to be able to come to you when they're feeling bad.
That was an awesome handstand, you silly goose.
And sooner or later, all those feelings being stuffed down are going to explode just like a volcano.
Go, come on, Ashley.
6 maanden nadat de 7-jarige Ashley met een gebroken enkel het strijdveld introk.
Just don't make it too tight, Bruce.
Brak ze haar andere enkel tijdens de training voor een wedstrijd.
Very good.
She's had a hard year.
Oh, try that again.
You know, 2 breaks and 3 months of restriction in training put a crimp in your style.
Come on, baby, you gotta get 20. Come on. 18.
Wat de grens is tussen dwingen en aanmoedigen is steeds minder duidelijk voor Ashley's ouders.
Her poor ankle.
For every 1,000 girls to try to be a champion, maybe one or 1/10 of one make it.
Sharp. I love the innocence of childhood when they just know that they're going to go to the Olympics and that's their dream.
There are a lot of gyms, some of which teach gymnastics as a pleasurable sport, some of which aim for the sky. And if you're aiming for the sky, I think you're likely to crash.
It's over.
Kinderen hopend op een Olympische medaille. Maar ook hier in Vlaanderen zijn er enkele scholen waar jongeren worden klaargestoomd voor een blitzcarrière. Zo is er in Meulebeek het VILO, waar jongeren worden opgeleid tot topsporter. En in de balletschool in Antwerpen dromen alle jonge dansertjes ervan om ooit heel erg groot te worden.